What kind of successful commercial deployments have happened so far in blockchain?
It's still very early days. So we service both startups and corporates. The startups have been running really quickly and deploying into production environments. And some of those solutions ultimately serve enterprises and corporates. On the other hand, the corporates, we've been working at a different pace. So we've got lots of proof of concept.
Like longer development cycle.
Yes.
Planning cycles.
Planning cycles, but also the road to production is much longer. It's both a technical thing, so actually getting through the security and the governance and all the processes to take a new technology into a production environment. But it's also the actual acceptance of the new tech and seeing how it will build out in the corporate. And there's also, of course, all the commercial, competitive, and all the other potential issues around having a technology which is shared.
And so what's the long-term revenue model for applied blockchain within that ecosystem that's developing?
So we've started through a services business, so building solutions for others. That's given us a great position for seeing where the gaps are, because we've been building solutions for everybody using the existing technology, using the latest existing technology, but we can see all the problems. And we've been solving some of those one by one, and starting to build a platform of our own that sits between the blockchain and the actual applications that we develop. As I said, solve all sorts of problems around data privacy, keeping the application agnostic of the underlying blockchain, because the technology is moving so quickly. You don't know where you'll be in 2 or 5 years' time in terms of what platform you want to
use. No question about it, it's evolving rapidly.
Yes.
What you're describing there in terms of building a platform, is there a small to medium business market opportunity then in commercializing that platform?
Yeah, absolutely. There's also a balance between open and licensed or how you monetize these types of solutions. So we do initially want adoption, and so we'll be opening part of the solution. But we also see opportunities for this type of technology to be commercialized, especially with enterprises and their specific requirements in plugging into this type of platform.
So all those services arrangements you've created and all those blockchain solutions you've been creating, what do you think is the most likely industry to be disrupted in 2018 and into 2019?
It's obviously banking and financial services, I don't think they're the ones doing the disrupting. I think they have
new players coming in. Not
necessarily. I think that the incumbents in the financial services industry have the classic incumbents dilemma. In that this technology has a lot of efficiency associated with it and can potentially disrupt and eat into their existing business models. So it's very difficult for them to actually move in a meaningful way on that unless they're really threatened. And things are moving quite slowly all around. I think on the other hand, the bank's customers are the ones who are looking at this and thinking...
Demanding it, pushing it.
And demanding it, but also thinking, what do we actually want to get out of these these transactions, these processes? How can we make them more efficient from our end? And what does that mean for everybody else in the chain?
So a small business that's a merchant, for example, will have opportunities to get efficiencies out of the bank if they can push the bank introduce blockchain technology selectively?
That's correct. But we think also large players as well, who are still heavily dependent on the banks and these institutions. It's about the financial services industry, because most blockchain solutions that we see, even though they may not start with financial services, they typically end in a financial transaction. So it might be that you've got some very important data that you're exchanging. You want to make sure that data isn't modified, agreements are in place, and so on. But these ultimately drive financial transactions, or there may be disputes around those financial transactions, which again you can reduce by having the interactions prior to the financial transaction stored in an immutable ledger, shared by the parties and trusted by the parties.
So beyond financial services getting disrupted,
yes,
are there any big global brands that you think are ripe to be disrupted by blockchain technology?
It's a bit of a cliche now, but I guess it's intermediaries whose main purpose is to provide trust between other parties transacting. So where you have somebody in the middle, because the two parties can't trust each other, they can't trust each other's systems. That's the classic situation where this technology out of the box solves that problem.
Yeah, the supply chain examples, simplifying supply chain, making supply chain more reliable.
Yes, but also storing agreements of different kinds. storing data which relates to asset ownership, so registries of all sorts. And registries are particularly interesting because registries have lots of business and processes layered on top, and those can be, if the assets are captured in a shared distributed ledger, then all those processes can be made more efficient on top as well.